Is it what is the objective?
To me, you see, that is what we're talking about, the dynamism and the progress. Let me give you an example. Again, the 5,000 naira debate, right? Do you know that a lot of Nigerians were surprised and shocked that approval was obtained as far back as when? 2011, either in December or in May. I'm sorry, whether in December or in November. But when Nigerians mounted pressure, what did the president do? The president told CBN to KIV it, to keep it in view, right? So what we're saying is this, if that degree of awareness continues, right, a time will come, whether the government likes it or not, right? If there is objectivity, and if we want this democracy to thrive, you must listen to people. But like in the case of the Okibo report and the Gulf War windfall, people complained, shouted, all the activists. Did anybody see the report? It's still not in the public domain. So I'm looking at it, probably I'm too optimistic, but I'm looking at it from that angle. As far as I'm concerned, we are making progress.
Okay.
Take it or leave it.
How do you see this part? Because if you're optimistic, and the first term of reference was not just to consult with experts to determine and verify, that's the operational word I'm pointing out here, all petroleum upstream and downstream revenues due and payable to federal government of Nigeria. Now, if at the end of this report, it was stated at the footnotes that some of these figures are not verified, doesn't it make it a lot more difficult for even the government to implement this report?
You see, when you come out with figures and you were given terms of reference and you have a principle, right, at the end of the day, you need to be honest in what the scope, the successes of your assignments are. You're supposed to say, well, based on the responsibility given to me and the time frame, I was able to achieve this, you know, and based on the responsibility given to me, I got this, but I couldn't verify that. Why do you do that for management? And in this case, the government, is because you will not want the government to start spending money all over. You always give things, come up with footnotes on your, limitations. In researches, we do that. In everything, we do that. Even if you go, you read people, okay, we have like the Revenue Watch Institute and the rest.
But this is not a mere research.
No, but you see, what we're saying, if you go to people like maybe, okay, let's look at institutions outside Nigeria. Like, let's look at the Revenue Watch Institute. You know, the reports of people like Patrick Hiller, right? They wrote that a report before the presentation of the PIB, which was like a 9-page or 8-page report. After the submission of the PIB, you know, they submitted an 18-page report. Even with that, with their dexterity, they will get to a point where they will say, this and this is subject to that. That's an example. Another example is somebody, people like Paul Collier, right, of Oxford University, that people praise here. And I think he was in Nigeria probably last week or there. If you read that, his book, The Plundered Planet, where he talked about endowment and resources and how Africa, and in particular Nigeria, must redirect everything about their activities. These people still end up and say some of this information are subject to this and that. If you are given a job by a principal, it is not expected that you will bring it 100% perfect. But the good thing you will do for your principal is where you feel you have lacunas, tell him or tell her.
You know, you used an instance earlier when you said that when you were talking about the National Assembly, and you said if members do not attend sessions, then they will not have a right to question whatever decision was taken in their absence. Now, someone might say that this scenario is a little different in the sense that maybe you did attend the sessions, but the decisions that were reached, you were not happy about it, or that you had a totally different perspective from the results that were, or the decisions that were taken in that particular session. So how do you then present your own differences if they were not taken on board in whatever decision that was reached?
And you see, some of us, you, the media, especially the electronic and print media, you had access to some of these clips that were displayed, was it in Aso Rock or somewhere, better than us. But from what we have seen, right, we are talking about a situation where you were already given a terms of reference and a time-bound objective, which will be like probably 60 days. And They even extended it to probably 90 days. And we're talking about a report that has been submitted probably more than 2-3 months ago. And somebody is now coming. After a presidential order has been passed, somebody will say, so what? Do you know what it means for a presidential order to be passed? And you are saying, so what? And somebody is again saying, we should be manly. Who are you to be manly on presidential orders? Are you saying you will be, is that how to be manly? Is that how to demonstrate dexterity? Is that how to demonstrate management capabilities? You were given 2 months, right? You expended probably 6 months, and you will still come back and say that a presidential order should wait? I mean, let's be realistic. If for any reason you didn't participate or your participation is below the quartile, accept it. And there is a saying sometimes, even in the holy books, that if you don't have what to say, what should you do? Shut your mouth.
But assuming that that report truly wasn't ready.
I mean,
let's just assume that it wasn't ready.
Then that committee...
And they were still working on it.
Then that committee was not qualified in the first place to be... I mean, the members of those of the committee didn't have the necessary credentials to have been constituted.
Seen it before. We've seen this happen before. I mean, it was even... through a committee, on a committee that Mr. Oronsanya himself headed, who people say did a very good job when they were talking about merging ministries and parastatals. And they came up with an 800-page report, even though they had overshot their deadline, they had overshot the timeline by many months. But they came out with the results and they said, we took so long because it was a very tedious work to do. This is the result of our work. It's an 800-page report. How would you look at that in terms of what you've said right now?
Okay, if Mr. Oronsanya was the same person that made those comments, then he should have understood better that even in the case of this one, to some extent, you know, the degree of implementation or the precision of the report will never be 100%. I don't want to believe because they spent months or weeks or years in the previous report, then it was perfect. No. Because you are presenting report, the stakeholders or the people that are being allegedly indicted will be expected to make responses, just like what we saw on the LNG report, rejoinder. What was LNG talking about? LNG said, okay, if you say we do this, and this, there are terminology or there are technicalities like liquefaction. There are things we call regasification. There are things we call shipping costs. There are things we call net back charging. So, I mean, that is why you submit report. Then people will now come back. And the why I said this is a bit cleaner is it's completely different from the one that had to do with, as Nigerians describe them, the subsidy thieves, which were very clear. People could not even defend themselves. And the few that came to defend themselves, they demonstrated truly that they were subsidy thieves.
No, my suggestion or my question to you is it impossible if you've been given an assignment to do and you think that the assignment you have been asked to do, you're not been given enough time to accomplish it? Is it impossible to ask for more time?
You should ask for more time before the expiration of the report. Before the deadline, because anything could have been the reason why you wouldn't achieve your objective. Anything could have been, 1,001 reasons. But it behoves on you to tell your principal, your boss, or whoever, that based on the enormity of the assignment you've given me, I've noticed that I may not achieve it and give you an objective or the kind of competent report you are expecting from me.